game, man. We back in effect, man. You feel me? This is your boy D-Rail.
Cal. I go by the name of Lee.
What up?
Man, like always, each and every Thursday, man, Big Talk Big Game brings you that live entertainment that you want to hear, have to hear, and must hear.
Must hear.
This is Must See Podcast. Must Hear Podcast. 2021 ATL
Must See podcast.
You feel me?
Thank you for coming out. You could be anywhere, but you decide to watch us. We appreciate it. Shout out to the IG family. Shout out to the Hip Hop Network, everybody tuning in, man. We appreciate you, man.
Shout out.
There it is, man. And also, man, make sure y'all go vote for us again, like we tell y'all every show. Go vote for us again. It's 2022's ATL's hottest podcast.
Get out and vote, because we trying to beat Herschel Walker in most hottest podcast.
We won last year. We're trying to win again, man. That's all it is, man. So we appreciate you both. Appreciate the love. Hope everybody's having a great day out there, man. Hey, what we got going on?
Man, Halloween is coming up, man.
Yes,
it is. Y'all got costumes. Please tell me y'all got costumes.
I got costumes, but I ain't scared.
Ain't scary costume?
No, man.
You call that Flash?
No.
Who you coming at? Well, we ain't got to tell people who you coming at.
I know.
Okay, go ahead.
Stevie Wonder.
Okay.
I'm talking about with the dread start right here.
Oh, the Stevie Wonder these days.
Yeah, regular Stevie.
Oh, okay. Okay.
No, he can see a little bit.
Because he did get divorced, right?
Yeah. That bitch had to be ugly.
We starting off with
the track.
Starting off with.
Hey, he felt that wrist.
Oh. I feel like a bird in the sky.
Who you in? Who you going?
Who you going?
I'm going at a scary character, Jeepers Creepers.
Really?
Full get up.
Wings and all?
Wings, knife, hat, mask, long cape, gloves, full get up. Yes. Full get up.
Wow.
And I got the theme music I'll be playing in the background. Full get up.
It makes me look like light skin Blade. So like Blade look good as a butter knife.
They
about the Jewish people.
Exactly.
Yeah. Nigga said everything about the black community, nothing happened.
You right.
Soon as you speak on the man, soon as you speak on the white folks, they shut your ass down.
Hey, I say, you right. I was thinking about that.
And who on their ass the most? Who on his ass the most? The black community.
The black community. They can't know the black community ain't gonna do shit. They know the Jewish white people gonna do something.
Them Jewish folks got the money. Who controls the money?
Crazy.
Who controls the narrative?
Jewish people control the money.
Hey, but look, but at the same time, that man can do what he want, man. He let us know years ago.
What'd he say?
He said, la, 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 la. What'd he say?
I get my money.
What'd he say after that? La, 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 la. Then you can't tell me nothing, right?
Yeah, he did say that.
Excuse me, is you saying something? You can't tell me nothing. You had Jesus laughing at me. Can't tell me nothing.
J-Rock, what's happening?
You ain't never lied. It was a long time ago, man. And listen. I stand behind Kanye on this, man. Because it's like every time I'm up, they feel like they got so much control over us that whenever we go against the grain,
they want to shut it down.
Exactly. If it's not going into what they done put into the media and what they done tried to program us to do, you out of here.
I'm with you on that.
I'm glad he got enough money to stay afloat. He ain't worried about none of the bullshit they throwing at him. None of that, man. So I'm with him.
I'm with
and I can't wait to put
with
them Yeezys in Family Dollar. And me and my family gonna be Kanye'd out. Family photo.
But I'm with you on that. I'm gonna double down on it and say, yeah, I'm with Kanye on this as well. Because that's the first thing that came to my mind. I was like, man, so they shut him down because he talked about the Jewish people.
About the Jewish folk.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, when you talk about us, it's like everything changed. Status quo.
He talked about the Jewish community, but the white folks don't want us mentioning how the white people had us oppressed in slavery because it's facts. Detrimental to the white brain.
Right.
That's fact.
Fuck
right.
them.
Right.
That's fact.
I agree.
Fuck the white community. Fuck anybody who against us. Fuck anybody who against Kanye because of what he's standing for right now, man.
I'm trying to tell you because he even talked about us saying that slavery was a choice. Being a slave was a choice. That's talking about us, but did he get shut down?
No.
He kept going.
Hey,
look how quick they forgot about the White Lives Matter. Did he say White Lives Matter?
Right. That shit right. Matter. He kept going. Right. You know what I'm saying? He kept going. But as soon as they got on the Jewish people,
y'all think slavery was a choice?
No.
No?
No.
So you don't think Harriet Tubman would agree with him?
If it was a choice?
Mm-hmm. If Harriet Tubman was alive today, I believe she would be with Kanye and agreeing that slavery was a choice.
Slavery is not a choice. It's your choice to try to get out of slavery.
There you go. It's mental. Okay, back then slavery wasn't a choice. It was a law. But nowadays, slavery is a choice.
But like you said, you know what I'm saying, slavery is not a choice. Slavery is a choice to see if you want to risk it all trying to get away from that. Because you got to realize, this is a live or die situation. And if I don't get away clean, then I'm going to die. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that's a choice you make.
This is the thing about it, man. This is the thing about it with the Kanye shit. Kanye say a lot of wild shit. That's that man opinion. You know what I'm saying? Also, Kanye is a guy that takes meds. Everybody know it. He got mental issue. He gonna say some shit. If you got somebody in your family that you know like that, when you see him, hey, you take your meds today? You can tell. You know what I'm saying?
Do we seriously know that he actually takes meds, though?
He say that.
Yeah, he said it.
He did. Yeah, he having mental issue. He got the episodes. Everybody know Kanye ain't really been right since.
But at the same time, niggas say Orlando Brown crazy. He ain't lied about shit yet.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, it's the society today.
It's the truth. Niggas think the truth is crazy when it's too wild.
That's today's world. This wasn't always like, hell, Roseanne got fired for saying nigga on the Twitter. But that's what I'm saying.
Fuck Roseanne.
And you got LGBT people coming after people when they say some shit that people don't like, a popular opinion. Right. That's today's world. It's a cancel society right now. Kanye got money to, like, it don't affect him.
Back
like
himself that. Up, yeah.
But it's people that's always saying wild shit, has always said wild shit. It's just nowadays, everything is under sort of microscope of, or what he said, what you can hang on everybody's word, pull up old Twitter shit when somebody say something. These people's opinions.
I'm going to tell you what it is, man. It's a key word that's in there that a lot of people probably probably don't use, they do use, but I'm going to say it.
Roseanne.
In today's society, people are sensitive about every fucking thing you say, man. Whether it's racist or whether it's not. If it's not in your favor, right, or if it's not in your favor, people want to shut you down, say you ain't supposed to be saying that shit. They don't want to fuck with you no more. And it's like, why are you being so fucking sensitive? It's just words. You know what I'm saying? Why are you being so fucking sensitive?
It's today's society. I mean, at the same time, it's all like, listen, you got consequences and actions for your words. People got these companies and they decide they want to go with the wave. That's the wave of society. We can say, okay, words don't matter, but if somebody come in your face and disrespect you, they're going to have to deal with them consequences of whatever words they said at that point, you know? So they're using that same sort of logic in, oh, you say some shit about that I don't like or that's unpopular, that then people in the heads, they might think that they might agree with it. But because of the way it looks for the optics and you a PR team or whatever, you can't let that slide. So you got to, okay, we got to show we doing something as a company. As an individual, you might not do shit. And that's why these companies is pulling out, because they like, oh, everybody else pulling out? Why y'all pull out in the beginning? Everybody started to pull out after they, it's a monkey see, monkey do situation.
You know? But I mean, I would rather them say that they don't want to fuck with him no more instead of him shut them down completely on everything.
Well,
don't fuck with him no more.
Whatever company can do that, like, they don't fuck with us. Adidas say, okay, we don't fuck with you no more.
But is that on my Jewish people?
I don't know.
So it's not even that. It's just
the optics.
It's all about power and money, man.
Yeah.
Niggas know Jewish are financially stable, and if you go against the Jews, they so well connected that they can shut you down. So they don't want to be tied into what Kanye bashing them, because it seems like they supporting him at the same time. And if you support Kanye right now when he going against the grain, they gonna shut your ass down.
Because they controlling a lot of big money.
Most definitely.
And a lot of big companies. So if you say something, okay, example, you say something against the LGBT community or Beyonce or Nicki Minaj, they gonna talk shit about you on Twitter. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But they ain't controlling money like that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's like if we had a company, and a company was under Big Talk Big Game, and it was a white dude. And he went online and was like, man, and went on a podcast. Man, that shit, I hate all black people. You gonna take him from your company. Like, wait a minute. You talking shit, I'm the boss, and I'm black.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So it's the same sort of thing. Yeah. You can't talk shit, you know, but Kanye got money in other places, and a whole bunch of other places.
Yeah.
I don't think he expected everybody from everywhere to be like, okay, we move. He back here apologizing. He going on a campaign, you know, apologizing to folks. That's what's happening right now.
But at the same time, his point has been proven, though.
Yeah.
His point has been proven. Like, when I talk about black folks, nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing, because that's what they want you to push.
Yeah.
Keeping your kind down. As soon as you come up against them, oh, no, bro.
You ain't going to be saying
that. Exactly.
It's been said plenty of times. That's why you talk to somebody like Killer Mike. Like, you got to control the money. You got to put money in the community where you feel like it fit.
Yeah.
We fueling this same thing that he's talking about. Because we out here buying Adidas. We out here buying.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's why we've been doing saying that a lot of black people saying, man, support black businesses, man, so we can get to that level where we can be
like, what's happening?
We'll shut y'all Jewish down. You know what I'm saying?
King, what's happening?
You know?
Yeah.
So that's what we need to get. We just need to support black businesses. Black support blacks, man. And I'm telling you, we would get there with a Jewish.
You control the narrative. You control behind the cameras. You control the whole lot. Control the money. Control the whole lot.
Moving on to the next story, man. Brittany Griner has been rejected by Russia on her appeal.
Damn that bullshit.
So she's gonna have to serve her full 9-year term, man. Well, 8 years including the time she's already served. But still, for a fucking vapor pen? 8 years for a vapor pen?
The law.
8 years for a fucking vapor pen, man?
You're right. They use her as a pawn, man. She getting used. They throwing a book at her.
Sharing her ass up here now, too.
She a man, though.
That's what all women was. They're in Russia.
Y'all a strong woman. The pussy is tight.
Y'all see y'all want
to? Hey, free up, man. Free up. Also, another news. Have you heard about the middle school girl that stole over $10,000 from her grandparents, went to school, and passed it out to all her classmates?
Wow. Is she robbing them?
I'm trying to figure out, how did you get the $10,000? How did you know your grandparents had that money like that just laying around?
How old is high school?
She's a middle school girl.
Middle school?
I mean, 14 years old.
So you gotta ask. You know. That cash?
Like, had to be if she passed it out.
Should have been cash on. What's your cash out? Check it.
That bullet was happening.
Had to be cash if she passed it out like that. Said it was almost $14,000.
Hey, mama. Hey, mama.
What's up, mama?
Also, we want to let y'all know, man, please go vote. If you're going to do early vote or go vote
for ATL's highest, because,
man, go vote for political, man. Go vote.
Midterm elections.
Right, midterm elections, man. Go vote, man. Go vote.
Have a voice, they say.
Go vote, man.
Herschel Walker helped crucify Jesus.
Don't vote for Herschel Walker.
Is that who you wanted your office?
They're going all that man business.
Don't vote for Herschel Walker. I'm going to tell you that right now. Don't vote for Herschel Walker. I'm going to tell you that right now. Vote for anybody but Herschel Walker.
Herschel Walker cheated on his high school exam in Spanish class. Like, damn, they know everything about this man.
I'm talking about everything.
Also, another news. I want to ask y'all a question, man.
What you got?
Out of these songs, which song from each state do you think was banging the hardest? Okay. All right? Out of these songs right here, which song do you think was banging the hardest?
A state song.
I can trip a referee, tell by my attitude that I'm most definitely evil.
Let's go.
Blunt in the building.
You should. you here.
You look special.
What did you say? Okay.
There's a couple different ways.
Hey, that's a good thing. That's a good thing. That's a good thing. That's a good thing. That's a good thing.
How long was the bus you rode?
Did you have seat belts and two teachers in your classroom?
Were you at the lunch? Were you leaving as everybody was coming in?
Was your breakfast ready?
See, I was thinking.
So, so you know what I'm saying? So I'm just gonna get right into it and whatnot. Blunt.
Right? Blunt with
it. Is that, you know what I'm saying? Like, what made you come up with each letter as far as.
Well, tell the people what.
Right? That blunt, some folk didn't even know that blunt was an acronym. So, would you let them know what
blunt
the letter stands
for? And blunt stands for Black Lady Under New Terms. My terms, God's terms.
Ooh, that's all right. Black Lady Under the New Terms.
New term.
Capital Black.
Love under new manager.
Okay.
Right. You like that? Y'all
can't
take
it. So you have a series called Real Women of RVA.
Yes, that's my reality show.
Okay, and RVA stands for the Richmond, Virginia?
Richmond, Virginia.
Okay.
VA. Okay.
So what made you choose the women that you actually have on your show? Like, was it an audition, or did you already know who you was going to actually choose to be on this reality show?
God told me to pick. Yeah, he told me for that first cast who he wanted me to select, and I went after each and every one of them. It was very new to the ladies, so they pretty much let me, you know, do my thing. It was a good fit for some. It wasn't a good fit for others. So, you know, reality shows change casts now and again. So after the first cast, wasn't really feeling the dynamics of how reality shows go, we kind of revamped and got a new cast. And our new cast is lit.
New cast, okay.
So I peeped the accent, New York.
Definitely.
What part of New York?
I'm from the Bronx.
The Bronx, okay. So the show is Real Housewives.
Real Women.
Real Women, okay. That's why I slowed up.
Trademark, I don't want nobody coming after me. Andy Cole.
That's what I'm talking about. So Real Women of RVA. Why Richmond?
Because that's where I've been for the past 24 years prior to coming here. It's a city that needed to be put on the map. Richmond has a lot of talent. They got a lot of musical talent, a lot of people doing film and videography. But it's just like a small city in Virginia. And it's a lot of like hate within the city. So it's like, so I was like, you know, I've been doing my thing with the books. You know, I do books. they already knew me as an author. So I figured, let me use that love and expand to a different platform.
Okay.
And reality TV is something that I watch all day, every day.
Okay.
So I was like, you know, it's time for me to do my own thing, just like I said with the books, when it was my time to do my own thing with that. So it's a good look for the city, too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We got our reunions popping. We got our YouTube channel. We have a quite a bit of subscribers. Our views are growing. We're monetizing now. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So it's a great project, and I'm very glad that I embarked on it and God gave me that vision.
So you know what I'm saying? So this is what, series two, or is this coming up?
Season two for the new cast is coming up, but we have three full seasons of the original cast. Now, just because the ladies didn't like it, don't mean it's not a good show. Y'all check that out. Go to Real Women of RVA on YouTube. We're on Instagram, Facebook, Real Women of RVA on everything. Our website, you can learn more about the ladies. You know, just give us a try, check us out. We're not rich women, we are real women.
So you saying the ladies didn't like? So you saying the ladies is actually watching it didn't like it, or the ladies is actually in it?
The first cast, like I said, I had went and got everybody that God told me to get, and no one had done TV before, and no one had done reality TV before.
Mm.
And reality TV is it's a whole different
It sees everything,
you know.
Yeah.
And the mix of the ladies that I got together on that last season finale of the first cast, original cast episode, two of the ladies got into it. And
that's how that go. Like, that's how it's supposed to go. But for the
good part,
to me, you know, it was. We didn't capture the physical indication because my cameraman had left, which was terrible. But you could see as it was leading up, I had to grab my phone and, you know what I'm saying, get some extra. I had to get that.
Bring it up.
Follow followers. We had the camera stationary. That's YouTube. Was it really hot? Hell yeah. Was it really hot? I got one in
the car.
Ask him real quick. Ask him that question.
Man. His eyes ran down. Let's think about it.
Garble in hell. Like, no way I'm going with that shit again. That was the stupidest shit I ever decided to do in my life.
If you haven't seen it, man, go watch the Big Talk Big Game, take the hot chip challenge.
So you want to do it?
That hot chip challenge?
Yeah.
No, I'm not doing it. I've seen too many people do it, and it's, why would I?
You like hot food?
I like it, but these gallstones ain't having it. So Okay.
Keep yourself safe.
Yeah. I wasn't thinking about nothing health. I was thinking about straight up entertainment, and if I was doing that by myself, that video would have been a dud. 5 seconds after I ate the chip, I was up walking around. My ears had locked up on me. I couldn't breathe out my nose. The chip was just crazy. I was crying. I couldn't see. It was just a horrible experience. I felt like I was having a baby. I had both of my ears and that shit was wild. Oh my God. That shit was traumatized. I ate hot wings the next day and I feel like it sparked it back up. Oh, let me get this shit out. Give me some ice cream, man.
That nigga rebounded. Alright, so Blunt, so what led you? Okay, so you was an author, so we got, by the way, we got books. Was this one of your first books?
No, that was just a short. See, everybody nowadays, they're like, nah, we don't got time to read. But I just bought y'all a little something.
Oh, okay.
Just
okay,
a taste
of my food. Oh, I got time to read. I got time to read.
What
the?
Well,
yeah, I don't do that at my job.
My job ain't listening up.
I should have bought you a big job. And Halloween is the perfect time to read.
Oh, this is a good Halloween. Story. So, what's up with this book? What's ain't no love in these streets.
Yeah, it's a tale about two brothers. That go on a murder spree in Richmond, Virginia.
Okay. Long break. So you're saying no other streets about Virginia?
Yeah, Virginia is also known as Cap City. So, Richmond, Virginia is known as Cap City. It's like, what?
Bunch of lies?
Five.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. See, I would have thought that New York would have been, or the Bronx would be, like, them cities or whatnot. I would have thought there would have been, like, no love on them streets.
That's what the hell I thought. You know what I'm saying? I can't even get a awakening to realize what it really is with VA. Because he wasn't going down there for nothing.
Yeah, that's what it is. I was kind of raised in Virginia. So okay. I know. Not Richmond, though. I was in Newport News.
Okay, that's where Richmond was born. Yeah. And I had a fugitive at one point. And
Wait a minute.
You're going to slide by there?
Wild experience, an awakening experience, an invigorating experience.
One more word. I'm just kidding. I was enjoying the word.
Yeah, man.
Oh, she's waiting on the word.
Yes. Exhilarating.
Oh, shit.
You know what I'm saying?
I can't say it right now. I can slow it down. Shape the room.
Right, dude.
That's what's up.
So how long have you actually been in the industry or the game as far as writing books, as far as doing your acting, as far as reality? You know, how long have you actually been doing this?
Too long. I think my first book, Portrayal of a Hustler, was written in 04, okay. I think. But I've been writing in junior high school, winning.
So this is always a passion.
So this has been a constant thing until now. You got really consistent, like, you know, a full-fledged to it now.
Yes, we got like 7 albums. We got like 2 shorts and Carl Weathers Around the Way Girl series.
Carl Weathers? Big time, boy.
Yeah. So we definitely lit with that pen. We get that pen game in, for sure.
And so you pull your inspiration from your real life, or do you look at other people like, you know, I could probably write a story about that person right there? Or, you know,
Both. Portrayal of a Hustler series is definitely a depiction of my.
Is this a fusion situation?
See, like she's thought about it.
She's like, shit, what can I say?
I refuse to answer any question.
That case still might be
based on true events. The Portrayal of a Hustler trilogy is based on true events.
Oh, it's a trilogy.
It is a trilogy. We got Portrayal of a Hustler is part 1, Dead Man's Vengeance is part 2, The Vendetta is part 3. All of these books can be found on my website, which is www.4blunt.com.
We're going to have that right there. www.4blunt.com.
Absolutely.
We're going to have that right there.
You know, so we got that trilogy. Cool. Okay. We got the Everything Money Can't Buy trilogy that about to do a web series on. I put all of that in one book, though. So it's a trilogy all in one.
So when do you sleep? Because you got so much that you're taking on. Like, when do you just
kick back? I'm writing all of this. What I'm thinking.
It's just
waking up.
Look.
You know how motherfuckers wake up and check their phone? And a pen ain't got no ink. Let me get a little bit, please.
Like,
There's so many ways to get it down. Now, especially since you got the phones that you can just talk into, you got your Microsoft Word, you can just dictate now. You know what I'm saying? Oh, we did an audio book with a 32-member cast, sound effects, and the whole nine. Well, we took that thing to a whole other level with Portrayal of a Hustler as audio book. Yeah, music video and everything for that joke.
Them titles though, Portrayal of a Hustler, Vendetta, and what's the other one?
Dead Man's Vengeance.
Ain't no love in these streets. You out there, girl.
Like, for real, she over here trying to get revenge for real. This shit sound like mixtapes. Like, I just want her.
Yes. Wow. We do the music too. That's one of our producers right there, Phil.
Oh, we got your hands and everything.
Philly Phil? What's going on, man?
So is this somebody that, you know, if you're doing all this, is this somebody that's like a big name person that you would love to maybe get involved with your book or collab with, far from the show or something like that?
Yeah, I'm trying to get back at Carl. Carl doing big things, and you know,
that's a big name.
He knows what it is with Blunt. You know what I'm saying? So I'm trying. He brought LaJill in, which is a writer that I used to be affiliated with back in the days, and Carl has always been a loyal person. And very easy to deal with and get along with, and I respect him highly as an author, as a publisher. You know, he's treated me really, really well. And so if I could reconnect with him, that would be my goal.
Gotcha.
Okay.
For sure.
So I have to ask you this one final question, because I know everybody has this, whether they're doing something good or something bad, you have your critics. You have people that talk about, you know what I'm saying, well, you should have did this, I don't like how you did this or whatnot. After seeing and hearing all that, I know you take all that in and you try to, you know what I'm saying, critique yourself.
Yes.
What is one thing that you feel like right now that you like, you know what, I probably could do this just a little bit better to take my stuff from here to here. Not to say you're not already up there, but to take it from here all the way up there now. You know what I'm saying? What's one thing that you feel like you need to probably do different?
Hold off on putting everything out myself and doing everything myself. Real networks to house us.
Okay. Man, this is Brunt on Big Talk Big Game, y'all. You feel me? Man, ain't no love. Ain't that a song?
In the heart of the city.
Oh, my fault. Oh, I was over there thinking, ain't no love in the heart of the
city. Y'all trying to get me sued.
Baby, don't get the book, man. Ain't no love in these streets by Blunt out here.
Go check out, man.
sample game we call rapid fire. Oh. All right. We throw you some rapid fire questions. You come back with a rapid fire answer. All right. We don't judge. We don't discriminate. We may debate about this, but we want the people to know Bud outside of her business. You know what I'm saying?
Just personality check.
I love it.
We want to know how you think, man. If you want to know.
Right. What's your favorite cereal?
Captain Crunch.
Mm, the one with the table for you?
The Crunch Berries. Okay.
They dissolve a little bit. Dissolve a little bit.
So, if you have to go back and live with your ex for 3 years straight, or if you have to go back and live with your parents for 5 years straight, which one are you choosing?
I live with my ex.
Why your ex?
Wow.
Parents.
The ex still got a chance. You still got a chance.
Still got a chance, brother.
Y'all can't do it with my parents.
Y'all gonna wrestle?
I cannot do it with my parents.
Parents got you.
I left. First of all, I was on my own as a 15. So that goes to show.
That's a freshman in high school.
Yeah, I was a mother at 16, so I was already on the
road. Oh, he was out here. He was out here.
That's how she know. Ain't no love in these streets. Go check it out. Right.
Basically, that's a lie.
Right.
Give me the best compliment you've ever received.
And I was gorgeous. Like, beautiful is beautiful, but gorgeous is
that
the
big level. Word on it?
Did somebody say
it
to you today?
Yes.
Was it your ex?
No.
It was beautiful.
Everybody knew what to say, right? You gotta know what to say to stay, right?
That's why you live in the state.
Oh, yes.
I'm gonna take it back.
And he said that way. Your aura.
So famished. Beauty is an understatement.
Ooh, these words.
Gorgeous, out of this world, queen.
Well, you could go ahead.
They over there. They
over there. Oh man. So, what's a city you want to visit that you haven't been to?
Los Angeles.
Lit over there. It's lit over there.
I want to go. Listen, I've been to the West Coast, but I haven't been to LA.
You been to Las Vegas?
Yeah.
I've never been to LA or California, period. I would love to go there.
Listen, I'm going back.
Y'all going?
I'm going back to Cali. Cali is a little, man. You can smoke in front of the police. Yes.
What's your favorite fashion season?
Fall.
Okay. When was the last time, since you were writing, you sat down, wrote, hand wrote, and mailed off a letter?
When the last time my son was locked up?
What is going on in your life?
5 years ago.
You talking about Carl Webb? You need to link up with Tyler Perry.
Right.
That story.
Right.
I'm actually gunning for a spot in his establishment. I got a little
time back. Okay. Yeah, Tyler Perry's who you need to hit up.
Yeah.
Okay, when you're kicking back, relaxing, got a nice movie you finna watch, what's a snack you gotta be eating while you're watching that movie?
I love salami on crackers with different pepper cheeses.
Oh, okay.
Well, charcuterie.
A charcuterie board.
Either that
with the stuff.
Or you want a Lunchable.
Or lick a windowsill.
Uchi because I bought an Uchi on the show.
She said you bought an Uchi. So, I got a Gucci wallet. No money in it.
Would you get like the knockoff Captain Crunch?
No.
Crunch. Wow.
No.
Wow.
So you don't get none of that.
So you don't deal with the bag of cereal, see?
Oh, no. It got to be in a box. And
so she ain't dealing with the taste of yours.
Hopefully by Kellogg's. Somebody like that.
Oh, no, but them Fruity Crisp. Delicious.
Circle O's and all that. Like,
don't sleep.
Put sugar on top of the jack.
Don't sleep,
you know,
on the fruit rings and golden puffs. Them are busted.
Well, you know what? I'm going to try the golden puffs.
Yes, the golden puffs.
They kind of match the Captain Crunch thing.
Okay.
And I'm going to have a bet. And I'm going to let you know.
So we got to do that on the show one day. We're going to have. Cause they,
that
they
would
know
be
everything.
Great.
We're going to have the name brand. And the off brand, it's gonna be different stuff. It might be Dr. Pepper and Mr. Somebody.
And
you know what I'm saying?
You gotta try to guess what it is.
Yeah,
you're not gonna fool me.
You good? You all right?
I promise you, I know the difference.
Stay tuned for that.
That's coming. I promise you, I won't fail. Hey, I put money down on that.
Okay. We'll see. We'll see.
What's your favorite color?
Pink.
Okay. Mine too.
Is it red? I ain't mean to just bust
it's
up.
It's October. Brisk is over.
Okay, but you know what?
Oh, okay.
That's legit. I just went to a cancer event last week. That was a great response.
I love it.
Good answer.
Some lipstick and lies.
What's going on?
Oh, man. You know what I'm saying? So what's the last lie you ever told? Right around the corner.
I try not to lie. I used to lie a lot.
What was your favorite lie?
Somebody died in my family.
Oh, damn! I can't make it in there.
That was it.
You know what's crazy?
That shit got me fired.
I really hope my job ain't listening to this. Because one lie I always tell. Well, it ain't a lie, technically. So my grandmother on my mom's side of the family passed away. And we taking this time to get our minds right. Now, technically, she did pass away. It just wasn't recent.
Wow.
And then you always get to go back to work and not have to do so much. And I already don't do shit.
Because you already feel, they already feel like, oh, sorry.
They afford me that whole day because don't nobody want to give me their condolences.
That's a damn shame.
Right. Okay, right. But that's a lie. They go lipstick and lie, black women don't lie.
So sorry. How did you used to do it?
I just I didn't want to come to work at ass captive. It was, I don't know what was
work
going on.
Captive.
Yeah, I used to work at ass captive.
That's a flex.
Yeah, yeah. It was. Back then, I didn't really realize, nor did they realize who I was.
Y'all better recognize.
Yeah, it was deep. So I had told them that my sister passed. They tried to send flowers.
Oh.
The body won't there. And then my body won't there.
Wow. Hey, we sent flowers. She died. she was.
Yep.
Damn.
She was part of the community. Yeah, somebody shot her.
That's
ain't no love in these streets.
Ain't no love.
Hey, what's that? She died in Richmond. Y'all sent it to Atlanta, but we was in Richmond. We was in the Bronx. You know what I'm saying? We transported back from Richmond to the Bronx, so we probably missed it. You know what I'm saying? So
that's wild,
man. That's wild. We got Blood in the building, man. Blood in the game room, man. With Big Talk, Big Game, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So what we also want to do? We want to keep the ball rolling and keep the game rolling. We got to say what we call Who's Captain.
Who's Captain?
We want to know who's capping.
Not the cap.
Yeah, we know that's cap.
With E-Cal on Big Talk, Big Game.
Okay.
Love you too, Daphne. Okay, so Who's Capping? This is a segment where I give you two stories. I give you a title and an excerpt from the article, and you got to let me know if the story is true or if it's cap, okay? Guaranteeing victory.
Guaranteeing victory.
Guaranteeing victory.
Right. I'm
getting this right. I'm
getting it right. All right.
Because we don't know.
Star number one.
How do you help us out?
Dead smack. A Caucasian male allegedly broke into his ex-girlfriend's home and stole her mother's cremated remains with the intentions to sell them for money to purchase heroin. Charges against him currently are burglary and removal of human remains.
Damn.
Dead smack.
Wow.
Damn.
Okay.
Story number two. Booty bluff. A woman went to the DR to get a BBL for $3,500 and ended up getting her kidney stolen. Her friend stated that she thought she was getting the deal of a lifetime. Booty bluff.
Booty bluff.
I'm gonna let you know, the guests go first and choose which story she believes. Both is true, both is cow, one is cow, one is true.
Oh, so
go
first. Both of them could be true?
Yeah, both of them could be true. Both of them could be false. It's whatever you think, and then I'll let you know in the end.
I think the second one is very realistic. The first one is a little out there, but it could happen. But I'm gonna go with the first one is not true, and the second one is.
Okay, got cap true.
I'm going to go because I'm guaranteeing victory.
I think I got true.
I'm going to go with the first one is true. And the second one is cap. I can't see that happening, man. That ain't happening, man.
Both of those are real. Like, if you a fiend and you out trying to get my, like, I'm thinking Gator from Jungle Fiend.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. I do it?
So I'm going true.
Who about remains?
He was probably thinking it was like selling it as if it was cocaine.
They break those angles up.
I didn't get that.
Technically, it is.
Question of the day with D-Rail.
Or, in your case, a real man.
Why?
with no need from a woman whatsoever until he chooses to add one. A real man takes accountability. He's responsible, dependable, reliable. That's a real man to me. I'm not going to go with the God-fearing because a lot of people, you know, that's a whole other thing.
What about a real woman?
A real woman is someone to me who, again, can take care of herself wholeheartedly, doesn't need anything from anyone until she chooses to add someone once she's old herself. You have to love yourself. You got to deal with your insecurities. A real woman understands that she's not perfect, but she is enough. And that they are goal-driven. You can't just, you know, I don't want to do anything. You gotta want something. Oh, you gotta have values. You gotta have morals. You gotta have scruples. You know, and you have to have integrity. You know, you just won't fall for anything.
Right.
For anybody. So that's to me.
Gotcha. So you know what I'm saying? So I'm glad that you said that because as far as a real woman or a real man, speaking of the real woman part first, you come back in now. As far as a real woman, you can have a lot of women, like you said, you know, that can hold their own or whatnot. I'm not saying women can't hold their own, but you have a lot, some women out here that will say that they're independent, but you could tell they're depending on the man for everything to work out. So, would you say that those are real women? Because you got a lot of women that out there say that. They say one thing, but their actions show something different. So, would you say that they are real women?
I won't say that they're not real women. I would say that they are women with expectations. Okay. Not that they're not necessarily not real. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything about them can be stand up, you know, gung-ho. They just looking for that partner. Some women do feel like they need to be in a relationship or that they need that man to lead or that they want. A man, his role is to lead, technically.
So, in that case, I wouldn't say that they're not a real person.
What's your definition?
You know what I'm saying? My definition is exactly close to what she said. It's not a real man, a man that can actually take care of his own without any assistance, that could be like, okay, if all else fails, he still be able to hold it down himself. Yeah. He won't be leading all, oh, I got to go live back with my mama, yeah, or I got to go, you know what I'm saying, I got to go call my homeboys and bunk up with them for a while before I can get back. No, no, no.
Damn.
Real man, you going to figure it out. You know what I'm saying? You going to figure it out.
What if that's part of figuring it out?
Man, I always told, I'll be honest with you, I always told myself. No, but I'm just saying, I always told my son, and I told my parents this too, when I moved here.
Lifting Elisha.
Well, matter of fact, I'm going to go back before I moved here. When I actually started living on my own, I told my parents and I told all my family, I'm like, you know what? I would rather go homeless than go move back home. I'm being dead serious. Because I want to show the world that I can do this.
That's right.
If all else fails, I'd rather go homeless than move back to the crib. And ever since I said that, that's been my motivation to keep everything going, to make sure everything stays afloat, to make sure we never fail, to make sure we never even get to the point where we're going to be almost homeless, to make sure that we're not living paycheck to paycheck, to make sure I'm always thinking 6 months or a year in advance, like, hey, we're going to still be all right. You know,
yes,
you know what I'm saying?
That.
So that's what I'm thinking, you know what I'm saying?
So what's a real woman?
So a real woman, I would
somebody who never go back to their grandparents.
Now, I'm going to say a real woman is, like I said, close to what she said, you know, they can still hold their own, but doesn't have to depend on I have to be in a relationship to feel complete. Uh-oh. You know what I'm saying? You can be complete by yourself.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Like, don't be in the club saying, you know what I'm saying, I got my own house, I got my own car, I got my own money, but then, you know what I'm saying, but then you only got that because of what the man's providing for you.
Uh-oh.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't got this if he ain't got it.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm saying? So, what you need to do is pipe it down a little bit
and get your own. And then come back the next week at the club or whenever you come back, and now you can say your words at what you say. You know what I'm saying? Now you, cause right now, I ain't believing what you're saying.
What?
You just talking.
Y'all saying, you know, I'm just listening before the camera. What's, I'm not seeing much difference. What's the difference between a real woman and a real man? Or is there a difference?
I don't believe there really is. Gender is the only difference.
Yeah, it's just a gender.
Okay, I was curious.
It's a gender.
What you got?
I feel like a real woman and a real man can't need nobody.
Nobody.
You don't need someone to exist or sustain yourself. You just want to have somebody as a companion that you can grow with and you can build with, and you know you guys have like likes and just things like that. It just that brings joy. It brings pleasure. You know what I'm saying? But you don't need them to exist.
Because, you know what I'm saying? So you're saying right now, if y'all ladies duff y'all right now, you feel like you're not going to exist no more? You feel like life is over?
I felt like that, yeah.
I'm not going to feel like that.
What's
I'm gonna feel
definition
like I'm going to keep going. My definition of a real person is someone who's solid all the way through, you know what I'm saying? The same no matter what place they in, you know what I'm saying? So, like, solid all the way through. And it's male and female. Solid all the way through, honest. And, you know what I'm saying, got a cool vibe or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Don't got no attitude in there like that. What you have and what you have accomplished, to me, doesn't make you a real man or woman. You know what I'm saying?
I agree with that.
It's just short-term goals or long-term goals. You know what I'm saying? And you can't, I feel like, you know what I'm saying, not shit on what you said, but I just feel like a person position of where they are now doesn't determine where they're going. You know what I'm saying? Because we all got to start somewhere. You know what I'm saying? You independent now, but once upon a time, you was dependent on your parents. Did that make you a fake-ass nigga then? No, you still a real-ass.
I was a kid then.
I was trying to say you got a man at that point, yeah.
I mean,
you're still living, you're growing into a man.
But still, at the same time, with you still growing into a man, you still the real person you are. That's still who you are.
I see what you're saying. What you're trying to say is, and I feel like what you're saying is, part of that is what makes you a real person.
The journey.
Yeah. And see, I hear what everybody's saying, and I definitely agree with you as far as a real woman being whole, because you can really, especially women, easier to get into. I'm not gonna say it's easy, but you can get into a relationship at any point. Now, whether you in a relationship that's quality or has value is a different situation. But a lot of times, a lot of people use another person to validate their existence. And I think that's what y'all are hitting on when y'all speaking on that. But at the same time, as a man, I don't feel like you have to be all the way together to be a real man. Because there is moments where you have setbacks. I think being a real man is being true to yourself, right? And so if you absolutely need help, like, I'm like you. I wasn't living back with my parents at all. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
But people that do, I'm not going to say, oh, ain't no real man because he's back living with his parents. I'm going to say, okay, he's got to go through. You're going to hit some downs. You're going to hit some ups.
Yeah,
but as long as he's true to himself, and he ain't just on the couch like, Mama, meatloaf! Mama, like, you know what I'm saying? That person is true. You can still have confidence. I liken it to this, right?
Damn, meatloaf?
You know,
that's your go-to dinner.
You got to watch the Will Ferrell. But I look at it like this. It's just like somebody being ugly, right? You can be ugly, but you can dress nice, have yourself together, and walk with damn confidence. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So as a man, you can be down, but you can still be confident, strong-minded, and be like, I can get myself up out of this, regardless of what's going on.
That's Lizzo. That's Lizzo. That's definitely Lizzo.
Or somebody that's big. You got people that's big and, oh, woe is me. But then you got people that's big, like, I'm going to rock this shit.
Absolutely.
This is my way.
Like a flail.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Like, you wonder how people like that still get ahead.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? No matter what you look like, no matter what you carry with you, no matter what you've been through, if you can walk through life like, I got this,
that's
and you treat
right.
yourself.
Viola Davis.
You just gonna keep baby. It don't matter what's happening or what has happened to you, you keep your stride and you keep your strength, and you can even have humility, be like, okay, I'm down right now.
Yeah.
You know, and just recognize, just being true to yourself and just a man.
Humility
is
a big part of it.
Yeah, you gotta have that. Because you can't feel like I got it all together, because there's a lot of women out here like, oh, if he ain't got this, 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 they think the same thing. He ain't no real man. Nah, you're missing out. Because now you missed out on that back then when they didn't want me.
See,
you
missed on that. A lot of folks shape their preference as to what a real person is.
Exactly. And then, and a lot of people lean on that, you know what I'm saying, and say, oh, I need to get with a real, whether it's male or female. Right. I need to get with a real person.
Yeah.
Not realizing that you lacking yourself, what you bringing to the table.
Nobody's like, perfect.
You know what I'm saying?
Get your and I feel like everything we're saying definitely lumps into everything. Because I agree with everybody, what y'all just said as well, you know, to add on top of it, you know. And I think you're going to hear different answers when it comes from everybody in the world. They're going to have a different way of interpreting it. But I feel like at the end of it, everything that everybody is saying, it's going to still be like, you know what? I agree exactly with what you're saying.
Because when you say real, that's another word saying genuine.
Yeah,
indeed.
And that's being true to yourself.
And everybody has a different definition of real.
Yeah.
Right, right. Yeah.
What is the person on Instagram?
Lipstick and Lyle said they need to be able to be whole by themselves. We are to complement each other. And they recognize where they lack and can hold themselves accountable and find ways to be better.
Okay.
Oh, awesome. I love that.
She said, if a man know how to throw down in the kitchen, oh, he got a chance.
So all you got to do
is we just taught to cook. We know how to cook.
You might have to have a little future to be a tune.
Big talk, big game, game changer. Y'all hear this? If you know how to cook, if you're a man out there and you know how to cook, you use the word gorgeous. If you got a little fugitive background, you in there.
Blood looking for you.
You in there.
She choosing out here now.
But I appreciate that, sir. I appreciate that.
I like that.
But so y'all got any input on what he
said? No. Agree, disagree.
As far as what he said?
He's explaining his definition of a real man. Mm-hmm. What's your definition of a real woman?
A real woman is a woman that holds it down for her own. Like, it's okay to want a man, but you should never have to meet a man.
Big Ray.
So my thing is, I rather hold my own down, and what he brings is extra to the table.
Okay.
So I'm going to meet you halfway. I don't necessarily need you. I just want you to be around. So I feel like a real woman is someone that has confidence, that holds her own, that does what she needs to do, and then whoever comes along, they just extra.
Okay.
You just that added bonus. Okay. I think they call it that little, I guess, just an extra bonus.
An added bonus.
Okay. Yeah. What about you out there, sir?
I could be extra bonus.
I mean, I think it's a lot of different definitions to being a real man. You know what I'm saying? Like, somebody that's real very responsible to one group of people, that can be a real man. To another person, he takes care of his family. That can be a real man.
Right.
But it's a lot of different definitions. Like, for myself, for example, I haven't been on my own since, I'll say 12, but I've owned a business since 12. But the thing is, I'm a latchkey kid. So I kind of like raised myself since 12.
Right.
So, and my nickname on my dad's side is Man, because the way I handle myself as a young guy, but I still had the same thought process at 47 as I did at 12. It ain't changed, you know what I'm saying? And like, so to me, I've been a man since I was 12. You know what I'm saying? From somebody else's perspective, you know, they probably was a man when they turned 18. You know what I'm saying? So I think there's a lot of different definitions.
You 47?
Deep.
Wow, I would have never thought that.
So
real talk.
At all that.
It's time for the rank 'em
with L.E.E. Lee.
So I'm gonna give you some options. scenario, whatever the case may be. I gotta switch it up every week. So, and I want you to rank in order, you know, your favorite, your best, your worst, whatever it is I'm talking about, right?
Okay.
So in this case, you know, you do plays, you do acting, you do movies, you do, you got your hands in the entertainment world,
yes.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So, I got visuals. So, if somebody was making a film about Blunt, which you have an interesting life, as we discovered,
yeah.
You know, you had some moments. So, if someone was making a film about your life, your likeness, your biopic, out of these options, I need you to tell me who would produce slash direct your film, cast you.
Okay.
In your situation.
Okay. Who would cast
Blunt out of these situations, okay? Tyler Perry, number one. Tyler Perry.
Okay.
You want him handling, having the keys to your story, your likeness, and say, Tyler, put this together for me. Number two. Spike Lee. Spike. Mo Better Blues, Spike. Number three. Mona Scott. Y'all know who Mona Scott is?
Yeah.
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 Love and Hip Hop, all the reality shows, Mona Scott.
Yeah.
And finally, Jordan Peele.
Why did they have moved the cell time?
Bring him!
You missed the man.
I mean, it's a lot of them we got out here. Who do you think?
Who do you think?
Denzel
was one I thought of.
But see, I would think of Denzel more of an actor than a director.
He got some good directors. He
crossed over. You know what I'm saying? I would think more of an actor than a director.
So rank them. I mean, you pick all four, but rank and order your main option all the way down.
Well, my company is called A Blunt Joint, like Spike Lee Joint.
Okay.
So Spike Lee.
That's the first one.
Yeah, he would be the first.
You gotta let him put that. You know that motion he put in every movie where they like. They walk in, but they glide. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But, I don't know. Tyler's sort of superficial to me. So, it's like, I don't think he would capture. I'm from the streets. I just don't think he got it at
home. He probably got a Tim Fade wig. He come ready.
I knew what y'all was going to get to. So
Spike Lee, that's why I want to go to Tyler Perry Studio, so I can bring a little grit to the...
Really? So you think you... I like that, because most people are like, what can I get from Tyler Perry Studio? Now you're like, what can I add to make it?
How
can
I help him? For sure. I think Mona Scott would be second, simply because she gets it.
You want that drama?
She gets it. She, okay. Her background is very similar to my background. Read up on her. Tyler would be third, and Jordan Peele would be last.
You don't want to scare him.
He just out there to me.
Too far out there.
Yeah. I definitely respect and you know, admire his talent, but he wouldn't know what to do with me.
Okay. What y'all got?
I'm gonna go with Mona Scott number one.
Really?
Yeah.
I wouldn't have hit you then.
I'm definitely go Mona Scott number one, and I feel like Mona Scott, like, I like what she does, and I feel like, you know, if I'm liking what I'm seeing, I want to be a part of that, you know, so I'm definitely liking what she does. Number two, ooh, that's tough.
Jordan Tyler.
Number two, I'm gonna probably go Tyler number two. I'm just gonna go Tyler number two. I don't really have a reason why. I'm gonna go Jordan Peele number three, because I am into that scary stuff. You got scared? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I like dressing up as scary people at Halloween all the time, so I just like.
We can put a spin on it.
You know what I'm saying? I just like that scary. I like that type of stuff. You know what I'm saying? I like us. You know what I'm saying?
Like
nope. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
cool.
I like that. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know what I'm saying? That Spike Lee would probably be at the bottom for me. You know what I'm saying? Not to say I don't like his gigs or whatnot. I just feel like, you know, it wouldn't fit my type of character, my type of persona of what I push out.
Okay, I'll be so, what you got to eat?
Number one, Tyler, man.
Atlanta.
Nah, the gospel, man, the God in it, man.
Okay.
I didn't think about that.
You are a minister.
After that, I'll say Spike. You know what I'm saying? Because he makes sure, I feel like he includes everything.
Detail, very detailed.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Next, Mona. Because she can get that, you know what I'm saying? The drama out of it.
Yeah.
On the, if she don't see that, drama and how to bring it out of the characters and how they should respond to it. And last, I say Jordan Peele, because I don't know, a lot of these movies is done at night, and I just don't feel like he can capture me. Like,
yeah, he can't get done. I got you. I'll probably go Spike first, because I like his storytelling, the way he tells a story. He's going to draw you in at some point, you know what I'm saying? I would probably go with Jordan second. Only because he going to give you a story, but it's not going to be in a normal way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so it's going to make you think it's going to be different than what you've seen.
Yeah. And it's going to make you think, like, is that really going on?
Right. It might be slow for a minute. It might take a minute.
Yeah.
But once you get it, you're like, you know what I'm saying? So it's artsy. I like artsy shit. You know what I'm saying? Then I'll probably go with Mona after that, just for the drama. When she put behind stuff, it'd be the way she do it. And I feel like if you do a film like that, it's going to be some confession. It's going to be a different type of feel.
Yeah.
And then I go with Tyler. I mean, I like Tyler, but I like what he's doing, you know, for people. Right. I like that he puts a lot of money behind stuff. I think some of his stuff be rushed, personally. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Or at least it feel like that to me. But I like his storytelling and how he puts twists and stuff in. So, down my way. So just thought that was interesting, since you know. You in that world behind the camera.
That was very interesting. Yeah. I like that.
So now we do something real quick. I do a lyrical exercise. So these are all songs that we've all heard at some point. Right? So all I'm going to do.
Music, right?
I love music.
Okay. What's your favorite genre of music? You used to rap.
Yes.
You and Slim Jay got a lot of time.
Wait a minute. What was your rap name? Blood? You rapping about blunts?
No. I was deeper than that.
You, I can tell.
Who's your favorite rapper? You're
a writer, so you know.
Who's your favorite rapper? Let me guess. KRS-One.
That is my dude, but
is he like?
No. I like Rakim.
I was close. I said Lil Kim.
I said, bro, I don't say Rakim.
Rakim. I like Rakim. He used a lot of James Brown samples. Okay. So anyway, we're gonna do. I forgot what I had put down. We're gonna do some lyric exercise. Basically, I'm just gonna read off lyrics, but it's not gonna be in the cadence in which the song was originally, what you know and love.
Don't answer until he has finished all the lyrics.
They're fairly easy. I'm going to be real with you. They're easy. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm just going to do it.
That's what he played.
Bright lights, fancy restaurants. You already know?
I got it, yeah.
It's funny because we were just...
yeah.
And I was like, what? Okay.
But it's not easy, though.
Bright lights, fancy restaurants. Everything in this world that a man could want. I got bank account. It's bigger than the law. Should have lied. Still, I'm lonely now. Pretty faces from covers of a magazine. From their covers to my covers. Want to lay with me. Fame and fortune still can't find just a grown man. And I'm running out of time.
Without you, my life is incomplete. Who sings that?
Bright lights.
We just said.
Fancy restaurants.
Okay, that's all. Okay.
Everything in this world, man.
She got it.
Got a bank account bigger than the law. She's allowed.
Everything.
Hey.
I don't want to be a lonely fool.
that's not possible, tell me, can you weather the storm? Because I need somebody who will stand by me. Through the good times and bad times, she will always be right here. On a perfect day.
Sunny days. Everybody loves them. Tell me, baby.
Can you stop the rain?
Stand the rain.
Oh, close. Close. People.
Stand the rain.
People.
By who? Not the old edition.
The new edition.
There it is. New edition, everybody. Alright. Yeah. I need one more.
Okay.
I need one more.
I'm getting it on the first one.
So hard.
What? You gonna get this one?
Yeah, don't think so hard on it. Don't think so hard on it.
Yeah, just relax. Just relax. I'm not making it hard. Alright, last one. Blood starts racing through my veins. Man, it's just something I can't explain. Something about the way you do what you do, the things you do it.
Got it.
Blood starts racing through my veins. Something I just can't explain. Something about the way you do the things that you do.
This really a gospel song.
The blood, yeah. Blood starts running warm through my veins.
I think I threw them off.
I have no idea. You know,
blood starts racing through my veins.
Don't Google it. Don't.
But it's something I can't explain. Something about the way you do the things you do.
It. SWV.
Be right off of my feet. Can't explain why your love makes me weak.
You make this seem so easy.
Blood starts racing through my veins.
Yeah.
I get so weak. Girl,
and I also got a set with that song here. So.
And that's your lyrical exercise for the week, man.
So, bro, let people know once again how they can find you, how they can follow you, how they can watch your series, how they can just keep in touch with you.
Absolutely. So, on social media, you can find me on IG. My personal IG is 4Blunt, the number 4Blunt, B-L-U-N-T. My website for the books, www.4Blunt.com. That's www.4Blunt.com. For the reality show, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Real Women of RVA. Real Women of RVA, which stands for Richmond, Virginia. We have 5 seasons of content out there for y'all. We got all reunions, we got virtual ones, we got live ones. Y'all check us out. We definitely worth the watch. We got that movie coming your way, Until My Last Breath. Again, we got the premiere hopping off in Georgia in January at the Plaza Atlanta, January 22nd. Hopefully, y'all know how dates can be, but that's our tentative right now. And in Richmond, Virginia, it will be at the Bowtie Movie Land, and that date will be announced at a later time. So please follow me on my social media pages. On Facebook, I got my government popping. It's Kimberlaine Johnson. So that's KimBerlaine Johnson is JohnSon. So please follow you, girl. Please.
There it is. Excellent.
Good followers. Man, check out Blunt, man. She out here.
Man, appreciate all the people that actually came out here and watched this live in person as well, man, on IG.
Always, HHN family, what's up?
You feel me, man? Once again, this is Big Talk, Big Game, man. We're here each and every week, man. Y'all make sure y'all stay tuned in.
Yep.
Stay becoming game changers, man.
Bronx in the building.
Man, you feel me?
Lee Kiki.
This is your boy, D-Rail.
D-Cal.
And I go by the name of Lee.
What up?
Man, like always, we out here.
Lee Kiki.
Take care of yourself.